My name is Adam Spaulding. We are in Rita Tamayo's lab at the University of North Carolina, Chapel Hill, in the Department of Microbiology and Immunology, and I am a postdoctoral researcher. In Rita's lab, we study the bacterial pathogen Clostridium difficile, and we try to understand how it causes infections in humans, specifically how it colonizes people to lead to infections. The biggest impact it can have is death. It does kill people. The predominant disease is an antibiotic-associated diarrhea, but that can lead, in rare cases, to Pseudomembranous colitis or toxic megacolon. With C. diff specifically, it's very difficult to remove genes from the bacterium. And in order for us to understand how a gene is impacting disease, often the best way to do that is to remove the gene and then say, okay, now what's happening in disease? But because we can't do that, or we can't do it very well, due to this limitation of the tools we have available, one of my projects has been to design a plasmid, which is a circular piece of DNA that contains basically a piece of the gene that's similar. It looks exactly like the gene, essentially. It's the same sequence, and the idea is that in some random cases, you get what's called homologous recombination, and the sequences on the plasmid sort of swap out with the sequences in the chromosome, and based on the way you've designed them, they'll actually pull the gene out. So the gene is deleted and it's gone, and then you can apply that to looking and see how that affects disease. We don't really have that capability in C. diff, so one of my projects has been to try and generate a new tool that everybody can use to try and better understand how this disease is occurring. It's not all easy. In fact, it's not easy at all, but that's kind of what makes it worth it. The best things in life aren't free. They take a lot of work and a lot of effort, and we need curious people. We need people who are passionate. You don't have to be the absolute smartest person in the world to do this. You need to have passion, you need to work hard, and you need to have drive, and you need to want it. And we really do need curious, critically thinking youth to come about and make these changes and to bring in new perspectives and new lives, whether it's from a science background or not a science background. We don't need all the same viewpoint. We need diversity. We need people from all walks of life to be doing this job.